Are you a sleepy guy who never wakes up no matter how much the alarm rings? So today I have solution for your problem. No, not this way. Welcome to CreativeJE. In this video, we will be making this Arduino based portable watch which will give you an electric shock at 5 a.m.
3, 4
to wake you up instantly without making any noise. Shivam is here, so you don't need to go anywhere. Let's get started. First, let's talk about what's the idea behind this project. I got this idea from the shocking pen which you can get from a toy store or an online store in just $few. When you press the button of the pen, it gives you an electric shock which is quite less, so it's not gonna kill you. And you can see the little circuit present inside this toy. So when you will provide around 5 volts to the circuit, it will generate an equivalent AC voltage to the output. Now we will have to feed the voltage to the circuit on a specific time so that the person gets shock at that time. But how we will do that? How? No, you guys are not dumbass. I know, you all are genius. That's why you come to watch my videos. The answer is simple. We will use a microcontroller, an Arduino Nano. But you can use whatever you want, like Arduino Pro Mini or ESP32. But I wanted to keep this project simple so that you can follow easily. And after that, we need to display time and alarm. So we will need a display. No, not this. This one, which is an OLED I2C display, which means you can control it by using just 2 wires, serial data and serial clock. Now what? How will you power everything? With your warm pee. Nah. With a 3.7 volt of LiPo battery having capacity of 500 mAh and of course a charging module with 5 volt booster included. But wait, how will you change the settings? With your nose, yeah. So we will add tactile push buttons. Next, we will need a buzzer to buzz our ears before giving shock. We can't provide enough current to shock modules and buzzers, so we will use transistor. You can use any of the type NPN or PNP, but I will recommend using PNP transistor. I didn't had, so I used NPN. If you don't know about it, let me tell you about Mr. Transistor, the invention which changed the world. Transistor is just like a switch which we use in our daily life to turn electronic devices on or off, but it's not mechanical, it's an electrical switch. NPN means negative, positive, negative. You will need to look into the datasheet to identify the 3 pins, collector, base and emitter. It's really simple. Collector will collect the voltage, so we will connect negative voltage input because it's NPN, and emitter will emit the voltage, so we will connect negative output of the LED, or it can be anything. And base controls the flow of current. If you will apply little positive voltage, the current will start flowing and switch will be turned on. And don't forget, we are applying positive voltage because it's a NPN, means negative, positive, negative. If you want to use transistor between positive terminals, just use PNP transistor, which means positive, negative and positive. We will just reverse everything. For more information, watch Great Scott's video on transistor as a switch. And at last, we will need some thin wires. These parts were for electronics, but what about body? If you guys are genius, you can make it with your own design or 3D print it. But you know, I am cheap, so I just cut a hard plastic of size equal to width of the battery and bend it from the edge. You can get few small straps or just take them out from cheap watches. Now make two holes parallel to each other and take some thick wires, insert it through the straps and holes. After that, just join the both ends. Do not tighten them much. And now our body is finally ready. Time to fire up our electronics. At first, remove the header pins from your OLED display, then just solder four different wires properly. Don't mess it up. Now connect serial data to pin A5 of the Arduino and serial clock to pin A4. Then as always, VCC to VIN, which will be 5 volts, and ground to ground. Now it's time to come back to your computer and go to create.arduino.cc. Click on Arduino web editor, then you will have to create account. I already have, so I will just log in. Now click on help, then click on install the plugin. Just select your OS and hit onto the download plugin. After that, you guys already know what to do. As always, install it. Just do next, 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 and you are done. Now you will see it on your taskbar. In Windows, it will be in system tray. So just click on it and open debug console. After that, connect your Arduino Nano to your computer through USB type B cable. You will see its port here. In Windows, it will be just COM3 or 2. If it's not showing, you will have to install the chipset driver of the board in your computer. I will put all the links in the description, so don't forget to check it. After you got the communication port in debugger, just open the project link and click on add to sketchbook, and it will redirect you to Arduino web IDE. Now click on the drop down and select other board. Type Arduino Nano there, and for flavor, I am choosing Atmega 328P old bootloader, cause another didn't work for me. I hope yours will work. And after that, hit OK. Now you will see the red cross is not there. The code is pretty simple, so let me explain. On the first, I have just included some libraries for display and button and initialize it. Next, we have variables for our time, cause we haven't used any real time clock module. And also we will need alarm time and shock time. The T interval is 983 milliseconds, cause Arduino timing function wasn't accurate, so it took me 3 days to figure it out. And D interval is for display timeout, which will be 10 seconds. And after that, we have initialized buttons on pin 5, 6, 7. Then our buzzer pin is 11 and shock pin is 10. Don't forget to connect them on the same pins you defined, otherwise you know very well what will happen. And rest of the code is all about logic for our time, alarm, AM/PM and buttons. At the last, we are reading analog voltage of battery and charging LED, so that we can determine when battery is full and when battery is low, whether it's charging or not. For your knowledge, 4 volt is the fully charged voltage and 3 volt is the low or cutoff voltage. And after that, just click on upload button. Your code will be uploaded to your Arduino board and your display will be turned on by showing the time. Now you will have to solder wires to push buttons. Just connect all the ground terminals together and others according to the pin defined on your code. I am saying again, be careful, don't mess it up. Otherwise, you know, shit will happen. Then connect buzzer to pin 11 and shock module to pin 10 with transistor. Now take the battery shield and solder battery's wire after removing the connector. Then solder wires on 5 volt and on the ground. Also solder one wire to the red LED's positive terminal, then connect that wire to pin A1 of the Arduino. And after that, solder one wire to battery positive terminal and connect it to pin A0. Now we will be able to read the battery voltage. After that, just add some hot glue and stick the battery and the shield. Now connect all the ground wires together including Arduinos. After that, connect all the positive wires together to 5V including display, buzzer, shock module and Arduino voltage input. And you can test if everything is working or not. Everything should be working. Make a little hole on the plastic and pass the shock module's output wire through it. Finally, fix everything into your body using hot glue. And now just take some thin aluminum foils and solder it to the output of the shock module. And then glue it at the back using Fabiquick. Yeah, we made it. So you can see it's fully functional, but I just broke one button wire, so please be careful while gluing them. You can also upload code again from the side and charge it. The charging indicator will show up on screen and the battery life is around 10 to 12 hours. Let's set an alarm. Hold mode button for 2 seconds, then change your time. Press it again to go to the next setting, set alarm. Set shock time and now wait. First, the buzzer will buzz for 10 seconds and after that, it will give you shock with the probes behind.
Ouch!
It's portable, you can wear it and sleep, but it's not water resistant. Sorry for that. And if you will check also, you will get around 5V with your multimeter. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. And yeah, remember one thing, anyone who stops learning is old, whether at 20 or 80. Anyone who keeps learning stays young. The greatest thing in life is to keep our mind young. Henry Ford. Please support me on Patreon if you want me to teach you more awesome things. And don't forget to like and share. And yeah, please don't go without subscribing and hitting the bell icon. This is the last video of 2018. So now I will see you in 2019. All the best for New Year. Bye bye.